Hello, my name is Roxanne Brown. What do you do when you've been brought onto a project long after it started? Change professionals often express concern about this situation because they haven't been there from the beginning. If you are in this situation, you might be asking yourself, how can I succeed? Well, there are actually lots of things that you can do to succeed in this situation, and so that's what I'm going to focus on in this video. Before I talk about what you can do, let's talk for a minute about why this is so common. There are lots of reasons. It really runs the gamut. So, for example, maybe the leader did not know about change management, didn't know that change management is a process, not just a concept. Or maybe they did know, but they didn't know how to find someone who could do the work. There are other reasons, like practical reasons. For example, you just might not have been available when the project started, or maybe there wasn't budget approval to bring you on. So that could be a reason why you're brought in late. Another reason could be that it was just underestimated the amount of change or amount of impact that people would experience with the change. And so it's just come to light that change management needs to be an important part of the project strategy. Because there are so many reasons why this can occur, it's really important as a change professional not only to be unsurprised that this could happen, but be ready to handle the situation. When I'm in this situation, I do two things: take care of immediate needs while building a strategy. What do I mean by immediate needs? Well, when I join a project that's been going on for a while, I typically discover that there's some difficulty in the situation, and that can come in many forms. It could be that the leader is working hard to manage expectations or overcome opposition to the change they're introducing. Or maybe the project team is fielding a lot of questions they just can't answer yet. Or stakeholders may be upset because they feel that they haven't been appropriately engaged in the initiative to this point. Or employees might be scared of the change, and you find that they are disengaged or even frozen. So these are the kinds of things that you can find that are pretty typical when you've joined an initiative that's been going on for a while. As a change professional, it's not unusual to join a project and find that there is some pain in the environment. Addressing immediate needs like these is often a focus on communication, helping leaders understand what people need to hear from them, giving project teams information that they can share, and setting up a way to communicate regularly with everyone in a way that they would expect and that demonstrates that their role is understood and respected. Focusing here builds trust in both the initiative and leadership. It also brings calm to the environment, which is probably something the project really needs at this point. Bringing calm to the environment means that the work of the project can be the focus. While I'm doing this, I'm also gathering information to build my strategy. So I'm trying to understand who is involved in the change and what the change means to them, as well as what it means specifically in terms of impact to their role. While I'm addressing immediate needs, I'm also building for the long term. This is a great opportunity to build relationships with leaders and influencers and stakeholders, especially if you listen for what they need and respond with what's reasonable. By bringing calm to the environment, you'll boost others' confidence in your ability to guide everyone through a change process in a way that's right for the company. So while this is a lot of work, absolutely, there are several possible positive outcomes. I hope this gives you some things to think about adding to your approach and some ideas for how to handle this situation in the future. Thank you for listening.